One thing we found out in Kathmandu is friends, guy friends, hold each other around town like this. Not like that, but they'll hold hands.
I'm not into it.
It's a little disturbing.
Okay, we're here at the Lukla airstrip. It's about, I don't know, 1,500 foot.
We should go look.
Yeah, we'll go look. But it's a big drop. So we just filmed some planes coming in and taking off. When we were flying in, I looked out the pilot window and you could just see this little teeny mountain airstrip. The plane almost stalled up there. They just hit the brakes, turned it up like this, and it started into that mountain airstrip.
Here's the runway. Here's the plane. The last second, they nose up, bang, and then skid up the ramp.
And this tarmac right here was originally put here by Hillary. It was dirt. It was to bring sick people out of here and get them to Kathmandu. Now it's obviously asphalt, but it's uphill so that the plane has enough time to stop because it's not very long.
It's short. Short. Very short.
Are the remains of what seems to be an airplane. Oddly enough, we're about 15 feet away from the first stretch of the landing strip, probably about where the planes are touching down. So one can't help but wonder if this is merely an accident or decoration.
Do you think they have a lot of decoration up here?
I'm guessing no. They're probably not too worried about the aesthetics.
Everything's magic.
I'm glad we saw this after we landed.
We still gotta fly out of here.
True. Hopefully I'll forget by then.
And I'm surprised at how cold it is here. And we're at the bottom.
This is the warmest it's gonna be for the next 3 weeks.
True. I think I speak for us all when I say words cannot describe what it was like to fly into this little airstrip.
Goosebumps, not from the cold, but just from being here.
Yeah. Oh, this is
a big goosebump.
This is not real.
I mean, this is defining a life, I think.
It's amazing. You guys feel completely alive. I feel like every sense is just going off.
I'm certain, and I feel that this is probably verifiable, but of all the people that have ever been to Lukla, no one as good as us.
That's right. People have been partying as Abe walks down the sidewalk.
Right, we're here with Sanjeev.
Right.
How long you been doing this?
More than 20 years.
20? 21?
Maybe more, yeah, something like that.
And of all the groups you've ever taken, clearly we are your very favorite.
Look who's talking.
Oh, no. So, how many days will we be out there?
On the mountains?
Yeah.
So, we'll be spending 13 nights. Day 14, we'll be out to Kathmandu.
And what's the elevation that we'll reach?
When? Highest?
Yeah.
18,450, Kalapatar. Base camp is 17,600.
Now, if we get up there and the weather's clear, you just want to go on all the way up?
Yeah.
Just hit the summit?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. 29,000. Actually, when we do this track, you know, the climbs we do is more than 29,000, so you can say you've done more than Everest.
Woo! Tell us about the staff. How many do we have? Who's doing what?
Okay, we have four kitchen boys who serve us, help us wash the dishes, chop the veggies, you know. So we have four. Then we have one cook who takes care of all the meals. And then we have one Sardai, which you already met, Chiring Tendi. So he's the chief of the staff. So he does all the payments and stuff like that. And we have two shepherd boys helping us, you know, to pitch the tent, dismantle the tent, get the porters loaded, all the animals loaded. Now it depends, I got to check how many animals we have. They're taking the load on the other side to weigh, and then so we're going to have a few animals, of course, the animal driver. So quite a lot.
Now an important question.
Go ahead.
Do you think that those two deserve that kind of treatment? Look at them.
Well, I think...
they're homely.
I can tell you right now, no.